This very smart chap, he's named Marcus, and he has come up with an ingenious way of viewing massive point clouds over the internet or even on lower end workstations. This is what he's created, the Potree Viewer, and this is the web version that we're looking at. However, what might be of particular interest to you is the desktop version, because even on an old laptop, it can display massive point clouds, and you might want to hand this on to your clients. To begin, go to potree.org and it will link to Marcus's GitHub page. It focuses primarily on the web version, but if you scroll down all the way to downloads, the Potree desktop version should be there. Give it a click and it will open up the downloads page for that version. At the top of the screen, the latest version will be listed, and what you want to get is the zip file. So find the zip file, select it, and download it to a location that you are going to remember for later on. The file is only just over 100 megabytes, so it won't take too long to download. When the download has completed, extract the file to a single folder on your computer. And once that extract is done, open it up. What you want to take a look for is the batch file, the .bat file. And if you double-click that, the Potree desktop application will open. We don't have a point cloud yet, so let's go and fetch one. In this case, I'm going to use my point cloud from Metashape, but it doesn't matter what the origin of your point cloud is, so long as it is in either the LAS or LAZ format, Potree will accept it. Also, and very importantly, the point cloud must be projected. It must have a coordinate system. It can't be on the decimal degrees or degrees, minutes, seconds, or radians. I recommend using Google Earth, and we're just going to look for the UTM zone, because it's a generic system that is easily understood and everyone can transform from it. On the bottom right of Google, you will see the coordinates. And in this case, I still have it in degrees, minutes, seconds. And I'll want to change that to UTM or Universal Transverse Mercator so that I know which zone my project is in and I can select those settings in Metashape. Click Tools and go to Options. And then you want to find the radio button for Universal Transverse Mercator. Select it and apply it. You'll note now that the coordinates on the bottom right-hand side of your screen have changed. They may or may not make sense to you depending on how much you know about datums and projections, but the number you want to focus on is the first number, and in this case it's a 13, which means we are in UTM zone 13 north, because the project is in the northern hemisphere. If you're in the southern hemisphere, very simply, it would have been 13 south. So export your point cloud. And when you do so, you want to select that datum and projection. This is how you will find it in Metashape. Go to Projected Systems and scroll all the way down until you see WGS84 or World Geodetic System 84. Expand that out and scroll all the way down now, and we're looking for WGS84 UTM 13 North. Of course, if you prefer to work in the US State Plane System, in the British National Grid, the Hungarian national system, or as we use here in South Africa, the Hartebeesok system, that's fine. So long as it is a projected system, that's all that Metashape will require. Once it's exported, drag and drop the file onto the Potree Viewer, and you will see the option now to convert the file. It will give you a suggested output location. Usually that should be fine to accept, and click the Convert button. It will very quickly convert the file from the LAS format into the Octree format, which makes it so quick to view. And there it is. On the screen, the point cloud can now be viewed and manipulated. Of course, what we want to keep in mind is that in order to view the point cloud, we had to convert it. And that might be an extra step we don't want our clients to perform. So if we go to the folder into which the files have been converted, we will see the JSON file format has been produced there as one of the four files. You can now just drag and drop that file alone into your Potree desktop viewer, and it won't have to convert the point cloud. It'll just automatically show up. Simple as that. And you could now go about performing the measurements, the viewing, anything you might want to do to view the point cloud or present the point cloud to a client as well. Let's take a look at some of the tools on offer in the Potree Viewer. At the top of the screen, we have the point budget. where we can increase or decrease the number of points displayed in the view at any one time. Again, because it uses this octree format, it optimizes the points that are in the view so that you have the best viewing experience. We can also change our field of view by moving the slider bar. We have this EDL option as well, iDome lighting, and that just gives all of the points a bit of a shadow to give them some perspective and a three-dimensional look. You can fiddle and adjust these values as you see fit. It won't actually change the point cloud in any way. We then have different background options, including the skybox, gradient, black, white, or none. So let's stick with skybox for this presentation. We can also change the quality of the presentation of the point clouds from standard to high quality. We won't really notice much of a difference when we zoomed in like this, but when we are zoomed further out of our point cloud, it is better to have the high quality option. Then let's take a look at some of the tools we have. The first is an angular measurement tool. Click anywhere on the screen and it will pin to a point. And as you click to the second point, it will pin to that one as well. We can take a look at spot heights. We can take a look at distance measurements. We can even take a look at height measurements. All of these tools are very simple to use. Just select the tool and then click on the screen, the point from which you would like to measure to the point you would like to stop your measurement happening. You'll see all the measurements remain on the screen as well. So you can perform multiple measurements at any time and they'll be there later so you can note them down if that is what you require. When selecting this angular tool, it measures all of our angles with regards to north. So that would be 0 degrees. We also have a nice area measurement tool. And again, just click on the screen. It's always pinning to actual points within the point cloud. So remember that your measurements are in three dimensions as well. To clear any of these measurements that you've made, just click the X button under the toolbar and they will be removed. Next, let's take a look at the profile tool. We can view profiles across our data set from any two points or more points, in fact, if we choose to do so. Click your start and your endpoint, then right click, drop out your scene section, and click on the Show 2D Profile. And there you'll see the profile of the points that we have just drawn that profile through, along with quite a lot of details on the left-hand side. You'll see we can now rotate that profile around by clicking these buttons here. Alternatively, we can shift our profile to the east, the west, the north, or the south, just based on the orientation that we have drawn that profile on. And it's as simple as clicking the buttons on the toolbar and that profile will move about. If we have a look at the sidebar on the left-hand side, we will also see the width. We can manipulate that and make our profile either wider or more narrow, depending on what we would like to see. Again, just click the X button and it will remove the profile from our screen. We then have a number of navigation and view tools that we can make use of. One that might be fun to play with is this helicopter viewer option. Click the helicopter, adjust the speed toolbar, and then click on the screen to activate it. Now by using the arrow keys and your mouse in conjunction, you can effectively fly around the data set that you have produced. This is sped up, but by adjusting that speed icon, you can make it either faster or slower, whatever suits your needs. This might be very useful for fly through scenarios, and you could record a video of your screen to present to your clients as well. Beyond that, there are some standard view tools where we can view the point cloud from the left, the right, the back, the front, the top, and the bottom as well. This is all in real time, by the way, so the adjustments are incredibly quick. So let's go to the top view and take a look at the classification filter. So as we move down, we see the filters option and we see a number of point classifications. By turning these boxes on and off, if we have classified our point cloud data, we can choose to display just the point classes that we want to view at that time. We can also just turn them all off or all back on, or just one in this case where we're only going to view the ground class. And as we adjust our view, we can zoom into our point cloud again. And what we will see here is that we are only viewing those points that have been classified as ground, with most of the trees, the buildings, and other man-made features having been removed from the point cloud. What happens though when we click the reload tool is that it reverts back to a blank screen, an empty screen. So all of our hard work of loading the point cloud is undone. However, another wonderful feature of this open source tool is that we can manipulate and adjust it in a way that suits us. So if you just make a copy of that original Potree folder and paste it somewhere on your computer, you can create something like this. A customized viewer that automatically loads your point cloud. It has a welcome message. It's branded with your brand at the top of the screen with links directly to your website. We have the compass automatically turned on in the top right-hand side. And all of this can be very simply achieved by adjusting a few files that come bundled with that original zip file that you downloaded. You'll see in the left-hand pane, I've also compressed a few of the toolbars to make it easier to browse. To do this, you want to edit the index.html file. And at first, it might seem a bit daunting, but there's really only a few elements that you want to look for here. You'll see this section is where you can adjust the title box and a link to your website if you so choose. This next section here is where we turn those tools in the sidebar on or off, or compress them or choose not to compress them so that we can only display immediately what we want our clients to see as they open up the viewer. And we do that simply by removing the show text. If we scroll down further, this section now tells the software, in fact, how to load the point cloud. So I have added one extra folder to my Potree data, and that is this point cloud folder. So here it is, and you'll see that what I've done in this case is just copied those four converted files into that folder. And that's all you would need to do, and then you could package this up and deliver it directly to your client so that when they double click on your new BAT file, it would automatically open up the point cloud for them. There are a few options we can manipulate, such as the presentation. You'll see in our point cloud automatically we have the RGB values, but we could change this to something like classification or intensity as well. In fact, you could add an entire toolbar on the left-hand side of the screen that allows your client to simply adjust the material view that they want. You'll see now that I've refreshed the screen, we have the view of classification. In this section that's highlighted now, we would edit our welcome message. You could make that whatever suits you. And the number at the bottom of the HTML on the left-hand side denotes how long that welcome message will stay on the screen. You'll see here, if we adjust to intensity and save that and apply it, we can refresh, but it looks like we've made a mistake. You'll see how it goes blue. But this is simple enough to fix, and that's just a silly spelling mistake. So we correct that spelling mistake, we save the file again and refresh. So it just goes to show that even when we make some mistakes, we can recover from it quite easily. You'd likely want to make a backup of these files before you go ahead editing them. And as you can see here, even though we are changing what is displayed, it's not RGB anymore, we still have all of those characteristics. The classification is still there. We can still perform all of our measurements as we might want to do. So I'm just going to set this back to the RGB version, save it, and reload my viewer. You might be wondering then, to what extent could you change this viewer? Well, depending on how good your knowledge is of HTML and JavaScript coding, you could do absolutely anything you want, including adding a logo, changing the display style, all of the colors, the text format, etc. And as I mentioned earlier, it might be useful to add a section where you can change the view type. This is what Phoenix LiDAR has done, and they've used the Potree viewer in their online viewer, and they've customized to something that is unique to Phoenix LiDAR themselves. You see the color changes here, they've gone with the red coloring, but also with this material section where they can manipulate, if you see the points based on elevation, classification, the RGB, the intensity, they've gone the whole hog here. But this is something that you could do as well if you chose. And even though this is for their web version, You could do something quite similar to this in desktop version as well. Again, it's open source, so you can do whatever you like. You can go a very long way down this road, but you could also keep it simple like I have in the presentation and made just a few small changes to the HTML file. Once you've done that, you can just select those files, package them up, zip them off to your client, and tell them that all they need to do is double-click on the viewer.bat file, and there it would open like this. And if you want to know how to create point clouds that look as good as this one, click this link to learn more.